Thank you. At this time, we
and a very pleasant good evening, everyone. We are live at Airedale Arena. We've got the 5A West opener tonight. The Airedales take on the Panthers out of Siloam Springs. My name is Kevin Taylor. We've got the broadcast for you this evening, and let's get ready to meet the starting lineups. First off, the Panthers.
Emily Keene.
Siloam Springs is coached by first-year coach Bo Tillery. Marcus Ains is on his staff.
Number 11, Morgan Jones. Number 13, Erica Ellis.
Erica Ellis, one of the starters. Morgan Jones.
Number 34, Cadence Pendergrass.
Cindy Johnson, who's a sophomore. Emily Keene. And also Cadence Pendergraft, who's a junior. Now let's meet the Lady Airedales, coached by Chanley Bottoms. Her first year as the Lady Airedale coach. And let's meet the starters.
Get out of your seat and on your feet for the Alma Senior High Lady Airedales. Starting tonight for the Airedales, number 3, McKinley McHart. Number 5, Demaya Parker. Number 10, Kylie Poole. Number 23, Jaden Gramlin. And number 33, Jordan Gramlin.
Well, you got the Gramlick sisters,
assistant
Jordan and Jaden.
And Allie Arnold and head coach.
And of course, the other starting players for the Lady Airedales tonight. You've got Demaya Parker, the junior point guards out there. McKinley McCart and also Kylie Poole. McKinley and Kylie are seniors. And we're ready to get this thing going. Siloam Springs and Alma, they go way back to the 1990s. Coach Akins, the old boys coach. Dale Akins, back in the day, coaching the boys. And, of course, girls and boys doubleheader and always. And back in the day, it was a 4-3A, and now it's the 5A West. In fact, I believe I saw Monmouth State back in 1993. The Airedales defeated Siloam Springs, so on this very day to be. Tip's going to be won by the Panthers, and this game is underway. Lady Panthers come in 0-1 in conference play, and the Lady Airedales also dropping their opener. They've got more players tonight. Their bench is a little bit deeper. Had some kids out last week, volleyball weekend. Shot clock down to 15 seconds. And 7:35 left here in this opening first quarter of play. Game just underway. Shot clock at 9, and we got a reach in foul called against Alma with 8 seconds on the shot clock, so the shot clock resets. Kylie Poole picks up her first foul. Ball's going to be tipped outside. The Panthers have it. Moving things around, running a little clock here in the early going. That's Morgan Jones, number 11. Jones passes back up, clock down to 20. They're going to run a lot of clock, apparently. This is a good thing you got the shot clock because this may be, there's a long, deep three-point shot that's in and out, no good. The rebound, Kylie McCart, and here come the Airedales. Here's a layup. Jordan Gramlich came in averaging 16.2 points a game. She had 14 against Harrison, and she's got the first points of the ball game tonight. Panthers run a lot of clock and don't score. Nama runs about 15 seconds and they score. Panthers are going to throw it away, so Alma gets it right back. Good defensive set early from Coach Chanley Bottoms and her staff. First-year assistant coaches Allie Arnold and Garrett King. Garrett from Pea Ridge and Allie is from Greenland. By the way, they both struggled going up the hill last week. Going up the hill to Mountain Home. Here's a three-point shot up and good. That's Kylie Poole. And the Lady Airedales, who had a difficult time shooting against Harrison, come out 2-for-2. So a 5-0 advantage. The Lady Airedales have the lead. Here's a drive inside, and it's going to be a travel something. No call. Emma picks it up. It's a turnover. Here comes Demaya Parker across midcourt. Kicks it outside. That's Gramlich. Cross court to McCart. McKinley going to reset it to Demaya. We are under 6 minutes left here in the first quarter of play. A 5-0 game. The Airedales have the early advantage. Jordan Gramlich, the UAFS commit, kicks it outside. Here's the three-point shot's up, no good. And the rebound, Gramlich. Jordan put it up, had it blocked. It's going to stay with Alma. Shot clock had reset, so 33 on the shot clock. And the Airedales have it out of bounds underneath their own basket. Inbounds pass, they got to hurry to get it out. That's Gramlich, who's wide open, puts it off the glass, missed it. And the rebound comes down to Erica Ellis. Lady Panthers have it, they're coming across the timeline. So Lady Airedales 2-for-4 to start this game. That's a reach-in foul called against Parker. Two fouls on Alma, and again, if you're not familiar with the rules of change, no more 7 fouls and then 1-and-1. You get 5 fouls per quarter, and automatically it's 2 shots. So that's 2 team fouls against Alma. Still 5.5 to play in the first quarter. No fouls called yet against the Lady Panthers. Alma won both their ninth grade boys and girls last night. That girls team, man, oh man, they got some kids coming. Faith Sarter had a huge game, 20 points, and Olivia Hughes had 13. That's another turnover. Alma gets it back. Lauren Settle at 7 points. It's going to be a lot of fun to watch that team grow in the next couple of years when they get up in high school. Panthers have a little press in the backcourt. Alma's going to get it across midcourt. Parker breaks the timeline to Jordan Gramlich. Kicks it outside. Here's a three-point shot from Kylie Poole. Bingo! She's got two! And a timeout, Siloam Springs. It's 8-0 Alma. 4:50 to play in the first quarter. Let's take a quick timeout.
Don't your vehicle to just anyone. The professional team at Autoplex is committed to quality first and your complete satisfaction.
Back at Airedale Arena, the Airedales have it. 4.5 to play at the first quarter. It's an 8-0 advantage. A couple of three-point shots from Kylie Poole. And an early 8-0 advantage for the Lady Airedales. They're resetting the offense here. 4:15 to play in this first quarter. Shot clock down to 10, so they got to get something going. Here's Demaya Parker. Baseline three-point shot short. They got to hurry. They put it up. It's knocked out of bounds with 4 seconds left on the shot clock. So they'll have to get something going in a hurry. They got a backup player. That's Jasmine Labatad, going to check in junior. Get the inbounds pass. They're going to throw it away. And the Panthers are on the run. They kick it outside, and Siloam Springs drives inside, stolen away. That's Kylie Poole. He's played a nice first quarter here for the Lady Airedales. A steal, a couple of three-point shots. Here is McKinley McCart for three. Bingo! Hello, McKinley. 11-0 Alma. 3.5 to play in the first quarter, and the Lady Airedales off to an 11-0 start. And the seniors getting it done. A couple of three-point shots for Kylie Poole and McKinley McCart with a three-point basket as well. Couple of backups for the Lady Airedales check in for the first time. That's going to be Isabel Benson is in the ball game, and also checking in Chloe Gregory. Here's a shot down low, but a foul called against Alma. That's three fouls on the Lady Airedales. That's four fouls on the Lady Airedales. And no fouls yet on the Panthers. And they got two foul shots coming. That's Emily Keene, senior. Always fun when you get Siloam Springs in town. The GOAT, Jeff Williams, just walks into the building. Jeff hanging out with Alma coach Rusty Bush. These guys won't go back to college days together at Henderson State. One out of two, free throws good, and it's 11-1. Alma leads it by 10. Jeff now the AD at Siloam Springs. Here come the Airedales down the court. They get it inside and they throw it away. Yeah, it's picked up, and the basket no good, and then tipped away, and the Panthers have it. Benson had it point blank, couldn't get it to drop. Siloam Springs got away with the travel. Here's a three-point shot that's up and good. Panthers with four in a row to cut it to seven. It's 11-4. And it's going to be Alma's ball out of bounds. 2:56 to play here in the first quarter of play. On a cold night in January, it's, you know, you always talk about that August and September. Man, I can't wait for January. Well, guess what? It's here. Here's a three-point shot for the Airedales. No good. And the rebound taken down. They almost got it. I think they do. They keep it alive. Here's a little 18-footer. No good. And the Panthers get the rebound. That's Keene with the board. And stolen away by the Lady Airedales, who didn't give it right back. Panthers on the run. Here's a drive inside. No good. It's going to stay. Morgan Jones goes off the Lady Airedales. And the Panthers have it out of bounds. 2.5 to play here in the first quarter. We got a substitution. Checking in for her first home time on the basketball court. Briella Hughes will check in here momentarily. Jones kicks it outside. Here's a little drive inside, no good. Rebounded by the Lady Airedales. That's Jordan Gramlich. Here's Benson, top of the key, good. Isabel drains it, and the Lady Airedales go up 13-4. Well, the legendary Big Al in the house as well tonight. Big Al and Swain. It's always baseball season in the Big Al's house. Here's a backdoor cut. Panthers lost it. Picked up by the Lady Airedales. We got all the big people here tonight. Parker's got it. Going to reset it. Gets it outside. Now they throw it inside. And Benson, hold on. She was knocked down pretty hard. I think she's okay. Her momentum going forward. And the Panthers finally on the board with the foul. That's their first foul. 1:35 left here in the first quarter of play. And Airedales get another backup, checks in. Briella Hughes checks in, and Gramlich checks out. Here's a turnover, and the Panthers drive in, and another foul against Alma, and two more foul shots coming for the Siloam Springs Panthers. They're one out of two at the charity stripe. Two more coming. Free throw is in and out, no good. We'll get one more. Checking in for the Panthers, number two, Phoenix Moore. Free throw is up. That one's good. So five in a row, or well, five out of the last 7 points scored by the Panthers. It's 13-5, Alma's got the advantage, and that's going to be a timeout for Chanley Bottoms. 30-second timeout. Let's keep it right here with you and talk about what's coming up this week. We've got Russellville on Friday night, and the Lady Airedales and the Airedales going to hit the highway down the interstate. One of the easier drives to Russellville, about an hour away thereabouts. And the Cyclones off to a good start. Russellville boys like 16-1. They won their first game, and the Panthers, I should say, the Lady Cyclones, losing a heartbreaker to Greenwood last week, 71-70 in overtime. So they're going to be a tough team to deal with. So that's on Friday night. And then a week from tonight, Alma back home. So basically the next two Friday nights, Alma's going to be on the road out of town. Russellville on Friday and then Greenbrier. And the week after that will be on Friday night as well. We'll set the Alma roster for you on the court with the basketball is Demaya Parker. Briella Hughes out there. Chloe Gregory is in ball game. McKinley McCart out there. Here's a steal. Nope. Alma keeps it. They got to hurry. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Panthers have picked up their defense. Here is Parker. Drives in. Puts it up and in. Little left-handed shot. And Lady Airedale's up 10. 15-5 with under a minute left here in the first quarter. Panthers have it. Here's a baseline shot that's up and in. Basket made by Cadence Pendergast. Pendergast, I'll spit it out. 15-7, Alma leads it by 8. And that's going to be a turnover. Panthers get it back with 31 seconds. Shot clock is off, but they've got plenty of time to set up something here. Gramlich will check back in for the Lady Airedales. Good balance with the scoring early on in this game for the Lady Airedales. 6 points for Kylie Poole to lead all scorers. Seconds on the shot clock. Panthers inside the three-point line. It's in and out, no good. And the rebound, Alma. 11 seconds left. Here come the Lady Airedales on the run. And Gregory picks it up, kicks it outside. They got to hurry. 4 seconds. Here is McCart for three, and it's in and out, no good, and that'll do it. First quarter in the books. It's Alma 15, Silent Spring 7. Let's take timeout.
Autoplex is committed to quality first and your complete satisfaction. Our ASE certified technicians will repair your vehicle to pre-accident condition efficiently and quickly with a warranty on all repairs. On-site insurance filing and rental car available. At Autoplex, we look forward to making your experience with us easy in our state-of-the-art facility. Autoplex collision repair. Quality first, always.
Kevin Taylor back at Airedale Arena and Airwaves Media with you on a chilly night, January the 9th. It's going to be Panther basketball to start this second quarter. They were down 11-0, so a bit of a comeback, 7-4 run to end that first quarter by 8. As we open up the second stanza here from Charles B. Dyer Arena. Here's a nice cut back door, no good, and a rebound by the Lady Airedales. Jordan Gramlich has it. 16.2 points a game for Jordan. Kicks it outside. That's Briella Hughes over to Parker. 7.5 to play here in the first half. Hughes has got it. Gets it down low to Gramlich. Jordan goes up, and the ball is tipped. They're going to give it right back to the Panthers.
Seven
7:20 left here in this first half, and Alma's got a 15-7 lead, and the Panthers have it coming back the other way. Ninth grade girls won against Harrison last night, 53-23, and ninth grade boys won 45-32. Here's a three-point shot that's no good. Rebounded by the Lady Airedales. That's McKinley McCart. That's her third rebound. Under seven to play in the first half. McCart outside it goes to Briella Hughes, and Hughes throws it away. Trying to get it inside to Jaden Gramlich, and the ball was tipped around. And here come the Panthers coming back the other way. They find themselves down by eight here in the first half. Here's a shot, no good. Another rebound for Alma. That's Jordan. Jordan's got four rebounds. Here is Jaden, the left-hander up, no good, missed it. And the rebound, Panthers. Panthers drive in, put it up, no good. Another rebound for Alma. Briella Hughes on that rebound. Always love the fact kids are involved in Briella. Volleyball, basketball, cheerleading. Three-point shot from McKinley. Bingo! And the Lady Airedales extend that lead back to 11. It's 18-7. McKinley, a couple of three-point shots. She's got 6 points. Panthers on the right side. That's Cadence Pendergast. That is their program. I don't know if I've seen that name. They throw it away. Here comes Alma coming back the other way. Good pass down low. Parker up and in. Count it. And a foul. So the Lady Airedales, 5:32 left in the half, up 13. That's their largest lead. Alma comes in trying to snap a five-game losing streak. This team, 6 wins, 6-11 on the year, trying to go to 1-1. In conference play with a tough game ahead of them on Friday night. Demaya Parker has got four, make it five. So Demaya gets the and one. And the Lady Airedales extend that lead to 21-7. Here is a steal, almost a steal. Panthers hang on to it. Panthers have a first-year coach, Bo Tillery. And stolen away by the Lady Airedales. That's McCart, drives in, puts it up. And going to be a foul on the floor. That's going to be a couple of team fouls here in this quarter for the Lady Panthers. Alma's got it on the baseline. Inbounds to McCart. Parker's got it back. Gramlich kicks it back outside. Jordan's only got a couple of points in this game, and you got to love that. Here's another shot for Alma. It's no good. But it's good because everybody, other people are, you know, kind of carrying the load. That's good to see. Here's a shot for the Panthers. Three-point line, no good. Jordan's got the rebound. They kick it outside to Demaya Parker. Here is Gramlich, top of the circle. It's good. 24-7. Alma leads it by 17 points. And another timeout, Panthers. Full timeout. We'll be right back.
In 1886, aluminum was developed to first Coca-Cola was the Statue of Liberty is dedicated, and Citizens Bank and Trust in Crawford County open for business. We say they don't make things like they used to, and maybe that's true, but for over 130 years, Citizens has served the residents of Crawford County with the best financial products and services available. And like aluminum, Coca-Cola, and the Statue of Liberty, we plan on being around for a while. Citizens Bank and Trust, that's my bank for all of Crawford County.
Kevin Taylor, and we are back in Airedale Arena on a cold January night. I'm going to need somebody to go volunteer to warm my car up before I get out of here tonight. It's cold, man. And really going to be cold this weekend. 20 degrees, I think that's the high on Monday with a low of 2. I think I'll take a hard pass on that. Panthers have it back. They're down 17. Speaking of cold, they can't get anything to drop, and they've had some miscues. Alma with the big first half 17-point lead. Long three-point shot. That's a WNBA three there, and the Panthers crack 10. It's 24-10. Here comes Gramlich. She's fouled, and some foul shots coming. That's Jaden Gramlich. Jaden with 2 points here in this first half. And another free throw is coming here. Two free throws coming. Good, and she'll get one more. So three team fouls here in the second quarter on the visitors from Siloam Springs, and the next one's no good. Tapped outside, and it's going to stay with the Panthers. It was off of Alma. 25-10, Alma leads it by 15 points here in the first half of play. Good crowd on hand, got the pep band here, got the dance team, some of the dance team, the cheerleaders are in the building. Popcorn smells good. Here's a drive for the Panthers, no good. Another rebound for the Lady Airedales, that's Jordan Gramlich. She's got a bunch of those. Alma's going to reset the offense. Gramlich drives in, puts it up, scoop shot, no good. Jaden's got that, couldn't hold on to it. Pulled away by Morgan Jones, and here come the Lady Panthers coming back the other way. They trail it by 15 points. Here's a wide open drive up and in. Predegast with the basket. It's 25-12, and the Airedales turn it over. Not a good pass, and the Panthers have it back. Down by 13 points, trying to fight back here. Here's a three-point shot, a long three-point shot. It's no good. Jordan Gramlich, another rebound. Here comes Jordan. Puts it up and in. Missed it. And the rebound comes down to the – got a timeout and an injured player on the Panthers. So the Panthers have a substitution come in, and checking in for the first time is Miami Kinez. 2:45 to play here in the first half. Alma by 13. Panthers trying to fight back. And a steal for the Lady Airedales. That's Gramlich. Jordan, coast to coast, lays it up, missed it. And the ball's tipped out of bounds, and the Panthers get it right back. So 16.2 points a game, only has 3 points. Kind of scuffle it tonight, but hey, her teammates have picked her up. Really good balance, 9 points for McKinley McCart and 5 points for Parker. 3 points in the ball game for Kylie Poole. 3 points for Jaden and 3 points for Jordan. Panthers kick it outside, 3-point shots on the way. It's no good, the long rebound, Panthers have it. Went off the iron, and they managed to get the rebound. 3-point shot, top of the circle is no good. And the rebound, Haven Welch, who's checked in for the first time tonight. Haven's got a rebound. And that's going to stay with Alma. It's going to be knocked out of bounds by the Panthers. Two minutes and 8 seconds left here in the first half, and Jordan Gramlich back in for the Lady Airedales, and checking out going to be McKinley McCart. Inbounds pass comes to Gramlich outside to Parker. Back to Gramlich. 2 minutes left now in the first half. Parker going to launch a three. It's in and out, no good. Gregory a rebound. And Gramlich, that's Jordan, drives in and turns it over. Couldn't hang on to it. Panthers had a shot blocked. Airedales have it coming back the other way with a minute 30 left here in the first half. 25-12, Alma's got the advantage by 13. trying to get it down to Haven Welch, and the ball is knocked away, but Alma hangs on to it. Gramlich kicks it outside, and a minute 14 now on the clock. Shot clock reset, so it's only down to 25 seconds. Panthers have picked up their defense here in the second quarter of play. Here's a long three-point shot for Gramlich. It's no good, and the rebound. Wade Airedales, hang on to it. Under a minute left here in the first half. Here's Parker for three. That one's going to be short. And ball goes out of bounds back to Solomon Springs. 45 seconds to play in the first half, and Panthers a chance to get maybe within 10. With 45 seconds left here in the opening quarter. Alma led it by as much as 17, 24 to 7. But have not scored. Only one foul shot since that last three-point shot from McKinley McCart. Panthers get it across midcourt. 35 seconds left here in the first half. It's Emily Keene with the basketball, drives in and lays it up, missed it, got a couple of free throws coming. She's fouled on the play. Free throws up and no good, and one more to come here. Twenty-three seconds left in the first half. Second free throw is good. It's 25-13, and pressure in the backcourt. Panthers are going to put in a little blitz here. Brielle Hughes is in the ball game. Chloe Gregory out there, and Haven Welch in the game. Jordan Gramlich and Demaya Parker. The point guard's got it. Double team gets her pass away to Hughes. Here comes Alma. They got numbers. Good pass down low, but it's tipped out of bounds. With 14 seconds left, Lady Airedales have it. Panthers get a backup. Emily Sears will check in for the first time, junior. Comes outside to Parker. Shot clock has been turned off. Gramlich's got it. Drives in, draws some contact, no foul. Here's a three-point shot that's no good, and the rebound down, but they got to hurry. They can't get it off. Boy, a lot of contact, but that'll do it. First half in the books. Good first half for the Lady Airedales. They lead it at halftime 25-13. Let's take timeout.
Jordan Graham.
Jordan Gramlich with that basket, and the Airedales go back up by 14 now. It's 27-13. Third quarter of play, 6 minutes and 30 seconds to play in the third quarter, and double-digit advantage for the Lady Airedales, who turned it over, or they turned the Panthers over. Here comes Gramlich coming back the other way. Jordan's got 5 points now, by the way. Only three at halftime. Jaden kicks it outside to Parker, and they throw it. It's tipped out of bounds. It's going to stay with the Lady Airedales. 6:14 to play in the third quarter, 23 seconds on the shot clock. Six minutes and 10 seconds to play here, and the Lady Airedales have it. Going to reset the offense, 15 on the shot clock. They get it down low to Jaden, and Jaden, right side, no good, but she is fouled. She'll shoot two. .603 to play in the third quarter, and the first free throw good from Jaden, who's now 2 out of 3 on the night. Next free throw is on the way, and this one's up, and it's good. So largest lead tonight for the Lady. Well, no, one more point, and they'll match it. They led by 17 earlier. We lead by 16 points right now, 29-13. Now I'm going to let it halftime, 25-13. Three-point shot for the Panthers is no good, and the rebound, Alma. That's Jordan Gramlich, and then the ball stolen away. This is Jones up and no good. Another rebound for Jordan. Just kind of adding to her rebounding stats there. Kylie Pull outside for three. It's no good, and the Panthers have the rebound. Here's a wide-open three for the Panthers up and good. That's Emily Keene, and a timeout for Coach Bo Tillery to get his team set on defense. Alma leads it by 13 points, a 30-second timeout. Alma's going to be on the road Friday night at Russellville, and the team will be back home next Tuesday night. And then a week from this Friday, it's going to be Alma at Greenbrier. So, and it's kind of like football. You look up, and it's week 7, and then you look up in basketball, and suddenly you're almost halfway through the opening round of conference. Van Buren will be in town next Tuesday night. So the Lady Airedales are going to have it in the backcourt. Panthers are going to run some defense at them here. Inbounds comes, and it's going to be a foul called against Siloam Springs. Their second foul here in the third quarter. Got Jeff Williams from Siloam Springs, the AD here tonight. And we got a 5-second call, so the Panthers got a turnover. And Pat Witter's down there in the sitting on the front row, longtime basketball coach, former Alma administrator, and you can talk some basketball with Coach Witters any time of the week. Of course, two of his boys played for the Airedales, Garrett and Brock. Brock now coaching at UCA. It's going to be a push foul against Alma, 29-16, the Lady Airedales by 13 points. Inbounds comes to the Panthers, and they'll reset that offense. Got a new shot clock. They got a backdoor cut wide open, and they blow the layup. Wide open shot, no good. And the rebound, Jaden Gramlich. Here comes Alma. They've led it most of this night in double digits. They lead it right now by 13, and they turn it over. Panthers get a tip pass, and they're coming back the other way. Here's an outside shot, no good, and a rebound for the Lady Airedales. That's Jaden Gramlich, who's had a good night rebounding the ball. with the basketball is Demaya Parker, and Parker's got it across midcourt. Parker drives in, puts it up, no good, and Panthers have a rebound. 4:15 to play, and they almost threw it away. Here is Morgan Jones, kicks it outside, three-point shots, no good, and a rebound, Demaya Parker. Might have been tipped from McKinley McCart. Here come the Lady Airedales on the run. McCart's got 9. Her average for the year is 7.7. Here's a layup, no good. A lot of contact, no foul. Boy, Chan Lee not happy about that. Under 4 left here in this third quarter of play. Three-point shots, no good, and another rebound for Alma. That's Jaden Gramlich, who lost it and then commits a foul, and the Panthers get a chance for 2 foul shots. A lot of foul, a lot of contact on the other end, and then you get a little foul like that the other end of the court. Free throws no good. They have not, Panthers have not shot the foul shots good at all tonight. They've struggled mightily at the charity stripe, just 4 out of 9. Checking in for the Lady Airedales, Benson checks in. Gregory is back in the game. Line drive free throw is no good. They get a rebound and put it back in for 2, so nobody blocked out. And then a rebound and a basket for Morgan Jones. Nope, that's Emily Keene. My bad. Emily Keene with the putback. So the Panthers could get within 9. They trail it right now. Well, they can get within 10. They trail it by 11. And the three-point play is good. So Siloam Springs down by 10 points now, 29-19. Here's Kylie Poole for 3. It's no good. Panthers have another rebound. It's Emily Keene. Gets it across midcourt. And Parker almost turned it over. Did turn it over. Good play by Demaya. Here come the Lady Airedales across the timeline, and they give it right back. Panthers, Parker just couldn't hang on to it, and Panthers get it across midcourt. Here is Keene, little wild shot up, no good. Another foul called against them. That's 4 fouls here in this third quarter on the Lady Airedales. They fouled a lot tonight. And that's 3 fouls on Kylie Poole. Kylie Poole will check out. .309 left to play here in this third quarter of play. The inbounds to Keene. Alma led by as many as 17. And here's a ball almost stolen away. Panthers get the ball back, put it up, no good. Jordan Gramlich with the rebound. Under 3 left to play in the third quarter of play. Jordan drives in, is fouled. That's 3 team fouls here in this third quarter on Siloam Springs. Talking to Alma AD Doug Lockridge, Alma's going to play. They're going to keep on playing the Panthers in football. They got an open football position right now, but they will play. Here's a steal. Panthers get it right back. Alma and Siloam Springs will play at Siloam next year. Here's a layup, and suddenly the lead is down to 8, 29-21. And what a game for Emily Keene's got 16 points to lead all scorers. Here's a foul called against Siloam Springs, and now the fouls are even at 4 apiece here in this second half in the third quarter. It's going to be Alma ball on the baseline. 2:17 to play in the third, and what was a pretty cozy lead, 24-7. Panthers, in the midst of a 14-5 run, have cut it down to 8. Parker puts it up, no good, and the rebound, Panthers. Here comes Siloam Springs on the run. That's a travel. So the Lady Airedales catch a break with 2:01 to play in the third, have it back. Emily Keene, senior, with 16 points to lead the way for the Lady Panthers. You're back on defense. Under 2 minutes left to play here in the third. Allen needs a basket. They just need something to kind of keep it going. They had the first two buckets or the first 4 points to start this second half. Here's a pass down low, up and in. The layup good. That's Brielle Hughes. First points of the year, 31-21, Alma by 10. That's her first career varsity basket for Brielle Hughes. Siloam Springs drives in looking for contact. No call. Alma's got a rebound. Hughes on the rebound. What big bucket there. Alma kind of stopped a little momentum, and then they turn it right back over. Going to get a jump ball, and it's going to stay with, nope, going back to the Panthers. With a minute 10 to play here in the third quarter, a 31-21 game, Alma by 10. Panthers have it in their backcourt with a minute 10 to play here. Panthers running some offense. That's Johnson's got it. I got 21 points, 16 by one player. This is a steal. Airedales get it back. Parker with 45 seconds to play, kicks it outside. Alma's going to run some clock, shot clock down to 20. Third quarter game clock. 7 on the shot clock, and the Airedales, they got to hurry. 4 seconds left, and 3-point shot, baseline, no good. And the rebound, Alma, they got to hurry again. McCart up, puts it up, no good, but a travel. Or maybe not a travel. I think they called a foul. I'm watching the clock and the ball. 9.1 seconds left here in the third quarter, and 2 foul shots coming for McKinley McCart with those 9 points, a chance to get into double digits here. First free throw is no good. She'll get one more. 9.1 left here in the third quarter. Free throw is up. Missed them both. And the Panthers have a rebound. Keene lost it out of bounds. I think that's going to stay with Alma. Nope, they're going to give it to Siloam. 6.6 seconds left. Somebody must have tipped it. And here come the Panthers. 5 seconds left to get it across midcourt. With the basketball is Morgan Jones. Here's a shot that's up. No good. And that'll do it. After 3, Alma by 10. Lady Airedales lead it 31-21. Let's take timeout. Back at Airedale Arena, fourth quarter upon us, and the Lady Airedales have the opening possession. I'm about 10 points here in this game. Here's McCart for 3, no good, and the rebound. Stop me if you ever heard this name before, Emily Keene. She's done everything tonight. Bunch of rebounds and 16 points to lead the way. Panthers put it up and in. So they get a basket to open up this fourth quarter, and they trail it by 8, 31-23. The Lady Airedales have been outscored 16-7 since they built a 17-point lead. And the Airedales turn that ball over again. Panthers coming back the other way, 7 minutes left. Chanley Bottoms trying to get her first win, her first conference win at home, and her first conference win. Here's a three-point shot for the Panthers. No good, and the rebound, Lady Airedales. Almost had another turnover. Great hustle by Emily Keane. 6 minutes and 47 seconds left here in this ballgame. Alma leads it by 8 points. They get it down low to Gramlich, puts it up, no good, and the rebound, Panthers. Tough night for Jordan and Jaden. Both of them just have 5 points, but Alma still leads the ballgame by 8 points. Here's a little jumper for the Panthers, it's no good. And Jordan Gramlich's got another rebound. I bet she's close to 10. 6:15 left here in the game. Jordan kicks it outside. Here's a three-point shot. That's up, no good. And the rebound, jump ball, foul called instead against Alma. So team foul number one here in the fourth quarter. And the Panthers down 8. Have it back. Chance to get within 7 or 6, maybe 5.
Her third.
Thirty-one-23 advantage, and the Panthers trying to fight back. They get it down low. Here's a layup. That's good. And a timeout. That's Johnson on the bucket. Timeout for Coach Bottoms, and the Lady Airedales lead is down to half a dozen. 31-25. It's a full timeout. Let's take timeout. Well, getting a little bit dicey here by in the arena. The Airedales suddenly down, just are up just 6 points here in this game. They break the full court pressure, and a layup is fouled. Alma's got two foul shots coming with 5:40 left. They lead the ball game 31-25. They led it 24-7.
Her second.
And the Panthers have fought back.
At the line for the Airedales.
18-6 run to get within 6 points. First free throw is good.
And for Siloam, Kenley Moore.
It's Jaden Gramlich at the charity stripe. She'll get one more. Nobody in double digits for the Lady Airedales. Real good balance. 9 points for McCart. 6 points for Jaden Gramlich. 5 for Jordan. 5 points for Parker. And got them both up. We're going to call it in the lane. So only one foul shot's going to count in the lead. 7, 32-25. 5 minutes and 40 seconds left here in the game. Panthers across midcourt. Emily Keane, 16 points to lead the way, puts up a long three-point shot, no good. The rebound, Panthers is up, no good. Rebounded by Demaya Parker. Parker kicks it outside. Alma's going to set up with the offense. 25 seconds on the shot clock. Jordan Gramlich, they've done a really nice job on Jordan tonight. Jordan drives in, no good, tips it out of bounds. Panthers get it right back, down 7. Jordan just 5 points. She came in averaging 16.2 points a game. There's a jump ball, and it's going to stay with the Panthers. Alma's got a couple of points off the bench, which are always big numbers to have in a tight game like this. Isabel Benson, a couple of points, and Briella Hughes, also 2 points off the bench. Panthers trying to hurry, get the inbounds pass with under 5 to play. That's Keane, lost it. That's going to be off of her. Airedales get it back. 4:48 left, and some pressure in the backcourt from the Panthers again. Here come the Airedales. Gramlich gets it to Kylie Poole. Kylie Poole with 3 fouls in the ball game, 3 points. Parker, a little jump shot up, no good. And one and done again. They're not getting many second chances. Panthers have the rebound. 4.5 to play. They trail it by 7. Alma just 7 points here in the second half of play. Alma losing its opener on Saturday at Harrison, 61-30. Here is a 3-point shot. It's no good. And the rebound, Airedales. That's Jordan Gramlich on the board. Here is Jaden Gramlich for 3. That's good. That's a huge shot for Jaden. And the Lady Airedales go back up by 10 points, 35-25. So you got to like that one. Big one for Jaden. She's got 9 now. First 3-point shot here in the second half. We got all kind of contact down there. And holy cow. Pretty obvious that... Number 11, that was Morgan Jones, did not see the Alma player who's down on the court. So let's take a little timeout with you. Alma leads it by 10. We'll be right back. Back in the arena, I believe that's McKinley McCart, who was shaken up. Might have had the wind knocked out of her, and either way, plenty of good help down there. Doc Schlabaugh out there and Patty Webb trying to get her off the court. And I'm not sure what happened, but I know the Panthers were kind of running the play, and I don't think anybody, they didn't see each other. And If you've never played basketball, yeah, you just don't know. It's a contact sport. Let's hope she's okay and gets back in the ball game. 3:41 to play. The Lady Airedales have a 10-point lead. And the Panthers are going to have it out of bounds on their end right at half court. Johnson is going to inbound it, I believe, to Morgan Jones. Yep, here we go. That's Jones with it across midcourt. 3:35 left here in this game, and the Panthers trail it by 10 points. And we're trying to hold on. They led it at halftime, 25-13, but right now lead it by just, well, now lead it by 7. 3-point shots up and in. That's Natalie Perez, sophomore. And the Lady Airedales, who a minute ago had their lead cut down to 6, now lead it by just 7. Here is Alma for 3. It's no good. The rebound, the Panthers have it. I thought the Gramlich might be able to hang on to it. Salem Springs has got it with 3 minutes left. Panthers drive in, put it off the glass, and in for 2 more. So the lead's down to 5, 35-30. So a 10-point lead suddenly just cut down to 5 with 2.5 to play, right at 2.5. Parker drives in, lost it. And it's going to stay with Alma with 2:36 left here on the clock. Gregory's in the game, Parker out there. The Graham looks Jordan and Jaden on the floor. And also Kylie Poole. Got 18 seconds on the shot clock, trying to get the ball inbounded. Grambuck's got it, thinking about it. Drives in, draws contact. Holy cow, nothing. And Grambuck got it back, puts it up, no good again. Another rebound for Jordan. Jordan drives in, puts it up, and in.
Grambuck.
Well, if not once, twice, 3 times, and a winner. Alma leads it by 7, 2:15 to play in the game. 7 points for Jordan. 3-point shot for Keynes, up and good. Boy, what a night for that young lady. She's got 19. And the lead's down to 4, 37-33 with 2 minutes left here in this ballgame. Gramlich spins, puts it up and in. Jordan, 2 more. 9 points for Jordan.
Gramlich for 2.
And the Lady Airedales by 6, 39-33 with 1:40 left here. Panthers drive it up, no good. Rebounded by the Airedales. 1:30 left on the clock. Alma leads it 39-33, and they get it to Gramlich. Jaden's going to shoot a 3 again. Up and good!
Jaden!
Bingo! Alma by 9 and a timeout. Silent Springs. 1:20 left. Alma by 9. Let's take timeout.
Full timeout.
Well, the Airedales had that lead cut down to four, and then suddenly, boom, 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 back up to nine. Three-point shot from Jaden and a big basket from Jordan Gramlich, and Alma leads it by 9 points. Three-point shot for Siloam Springs, no good. Ball tipped out of bounds. Back to the Lady Airedales. 1 minute, six to play.
Checking in for Alma, Jaden Gramlich.
Good minutes off the bench tonight for Briella Hughes. Do not see McCart on that bench. Let's hope she's okay. She was shaken up a few minutes ago. Alma's got it back. A minute left to play in the game, and Alma's got a layup if they want it. And Jordan says, oh, take it, and a foul. Jaden Gramlich's got 14 to lead the way, and the Lady Airedales, how sweet it is, are going to win this ball game. Alma leads it by 11. Jaden, 8.3 points a game. She had 10 points in the game on Saturday against Harrison, 14 here tonight. And the Lady Airedales on their way to picking up their first 5A West win of the year, and Jaden missed it, rebounded by the Panthers, 54 seconds left, and Alma by 11 points. Here's a shot, no good. Oh, it is good. That thing found its way in. The Panthers get it to go, 44-35 with 48 seconds left.
Parker, basket's good. Cindy Johnson at the line.
Panthers have a free throw coming here at basket made by number 10, that's Johnson. Free throw is good. Three-point play. It's 44-36. Eight-point lead for the Lady Airedales with 45 seconds left. Parker's got it outside to Gramlich. Going to run a little clock here and a reach-in foul against the Panthers. Three team fouls here in this quarter against Siloam Springs.
Foul number 10, Cindy Johnson.
Inbounds comes. Here's a three-point shot for Alma. It's no good, and the Panthers have a rebound. Going to have a jump ball instead. Nope, got a foul called against Alma. No jump ball, and got one official right on top of it, and the other official a little bit further away called a foul. That's three team fouls against Alma with 32 ticks left, and the Panthers have it in the backcourt. They trail it by eight. Morgan Jones, number 11, dribbles, kicks it outside to Keene. Back to Perez. Perez drives in, puts it up and in. Nope, missed it. And a foul, no foul, rebounded by the Airedales. We got all kind of contact out there. Goodness gracious. Mercy. Oh, my gosh. Now the referees didn't see it. That reminds me of a play against Greenwood about 10 years ago. Holy cow. 7.4 to left. Alma's going to win it. They just got to hang on here the last 7.4 seconds. And the Lady Airedales have it out of bounds. Everybody in the gym saw that play happen except the referees. Inbounds comes to Gramlich. And the Panthers, for some reason, foul with 5 seconds left, down eight.
Foul number 10, Cindy Johnson.
So free throws coming for Jordan. And the Lady Airedales about to pick up their first win after a five-game losing streak. They'll be 7-11 on the year, and they will be 1-1 in 5A West play after this couple of foul shots here. Gramlich up and in. She's got 10. Came in averaging 16.2 points a game at 14 on Saturday and has 10 here tonight. She'll get one more foul shot with 5 seconds left. So the Lady Airedales will head to Russellville 1-1 in the conference. Two free throws for Jordan. She's got 11. And Alma's going to win it. They're up 10. 3 seconds left. Panthers get a late bucket. It's good. Alma wins it by 8. 46-38. Alma goes to 1-1 in the 5A West. Let's take timeout.
Stick around for varsity boys action. Now's a good time to go to the concourse and purchase your half-court shot tickets. Will be half-court time of the boys' game.
Yeah. Crabtree RV Center, leading the River Valley in sales and service for over 70 years. Founded in 1950, Crabtree RV Center has grown into one of the largest family-owned and operated RV dealerships in Northwest Arkansas. Located on 17 acres, including a 26,000 square foot indoor showroom, Crabtree RV Center has everything you need, all in one convenient location. Crabtree RV Center in Alma, Arkansas, making your family's dreams come true.
Lumber One is a locally owned lumber yard located in Van Buren, Arkansas, down on Industrial Park Road. We've been in business since 2002, and our vision is to provide quality building materials to the professional builder and to the do-it-yourselfer at competitive prices. Lumber One offers a full line of lumber, unfinished and finished plywood, engineered wood, cedar products, and LP smart siding and trim, along with access to James Hardy siding and other pre-finished siding. We also carry roofing, insulation materials, drywall, and wood sidings like shiplap siding, cedar lap and gap, and car siding. Our full-line door shop can handle all your door, window, and trim needs. We offer several different exterior door and glass options from Therma-True, MAI Doors, and Western Reflections. We also stock several different interior door styles from Gelled Wen, with access to their entire interior door line and others. We have a full-time estimator on staff who can do blueprint takeoffs and estimated material list for whatever project you have. He can work with contractors or homeowners to help you get your project started and answer any questions you may have. You'll also have access to an outside sales representative that will be there throughout the building process from start to finish. Our mission is to provide service at a level that differentiates us as the best in the marketplace. Lumber One, where service still matters.
You know, we may not all agree on everything, but when we walk through these doors, we can have one thing in common, and that's Jesus.
With all the stuff going on in the world, all the good, all the bad, this church has been something constant for me and my family four generations back. And something that can stay constant for my kids going forward. They're still the same church, and they're still the same people that I can still depend on and go to when I need something.
Heritage Portraits has proudly provided photography services for the River Valley and surrounding areas for over 20 years, including school photography and yearbooks, youth sports leagues, corporate photography, studio sessions, and event photography. Have you been meaning to order your child's school photos? Walk-ins are welcome, and we offer on-site printing. We are located at 402 Webster Street in Van Buren. Contact us today. We're ready to photograph you.
Spartan General Contractors is a construction company equipped with highly trained and experienced individuals ready to support you with your next construction project. Residential or commercial, Spartan has the resources needed to help you achieve your final goal. One of our main objectives at Spartan is to keep your project on time and within your budget. While the thoughts of your next construction job can seem complex and overwhelming, let Spartan General Contractors help alleviate that stress and make your next project become reality.
Here at the University of Arkansas Fort Smith, we do things differently.
Because here, learning doesn't just happen on screens and in books. We learn through action.
With degree plans that are on our terms, whether in class or online.
And because UAEFS is the most affordable four-year campus in Arkansas,
we can do it all without going into debt.
So when we graduate, we don't just have a diploma. We have a resume that will launch our careers.
Kevin Taylor back at Airedale Arena. The Airedales and the Panthers getting ready for a 5A West battle, and the Panthers come in 4-6 on the year. They're 0-1 in conference play. The Airedales 8-8, and they are 1-0 after that big win at Harrison on Saturday, 59-48. So congrats to Chanley Bottoms and the Lady Airedales, who got a W tonight. They knock off the team out of Siloam Springs by a score of 46-38. They won it by 8 points, and they go to 1-0 in the conference, snap a five-game losing streak in the process. So ready to meet the starting lineups, and we're going to do that with our public address announcer, the AD, Doug Lockridge.
High school boys matchup between the Siloam Springs Panthers and your Alma Airedales. Starters for Siloam Springs, number 2, Evan Allen. Number 3, A.J. Moore. Number 5, Stuart Swanier. Number 21, Nathan Hobacker. Number 32, Crew Webb.
So the Panthers getting ready to get it going. Nathan Hobacker, a senior, one of their top players. Let's meet the Alma starters tonight. Dominic Lincoln's third year as the head coach. Got himself a conference win on Saturday, and he's 1-0. Camden Kurd. They got this really good junior class, and Camden starts.
Carmody Smith.
And Carmody Smith, the point guard. Carmody had a big game on Saturday.
Number 11,
Miles Kendrick.
Towns Robinson.
Israel Towns Robinson
15,
had a big game in the middle. And Easton Boggs. Easton comes in quietly. I say quietly. 12.4 points a game. He leads the Airedales in scoring. And, of course, a big threat from outside, but he can also get you some inside baskets as well. So the Airedales and the Panthers, this rivalry goes back to the started playing same conference games back in the 1990s. Panthers, Alma's only had two coaches. Two coaches. In the last 30-plus years, Panthers have had a few. Dale Akins was a longtime coach for the Panthers for a long time, and they've been through a few since then, but they've got now their coach is Tim Stewart, does a great job. Airedales win the opening tip, moving the ball around, three-point shot, wings up, no good, and the Panthers have a rebound. Panthers are going to set it up on offense. Just underway here from the arena. Evan Allen, sophomore, they turn it over. Here come the Airedales, it's a run up. And a layup, no good. But it's going to stay with Alma. Ball's tipped out of bounds. Good job for Siloam Springs to get back on that. Here is Easton Box for three, baseline, no good. Panthers secured the rebound. Evan Allen, sophomore in the game for the Panthers, and he's got the ball right now. They swing it around, three-point shots up, no good. Carmody Smith the rebound. Here's a run out, Carmody to Izzy. Izzy's fouled, and he'll shoot two. 7:07 left to play here in this first quarter of play in the Airedales and the Panthers. Nathan Hobacker, a senior out there for the Panthers. Stuart Schwinger out there. He picked up the foul. Towns Robinson, one more free throw. 16 points and 8 rebounds in Saturday's game against Harrison. Izzy, 1 out of 2. Alma leads 1-0. Well, the Lady Airedales got off to a big lead, 11-0 to start the game. Led it 24-7. They hang on and win it 46-38. Yeah, you go to 1-0. Or 1-1 in the conference. Here's a drive up and no good, but a foul called against Alma. And Schwinger at the charity stripe for two. It's 6:52 to play in the first quarter.
Stuart Swanger at the line for the Panthers.
Free throws up and good. He'll get one more. Alma trailed at Harrison Saturday by 8 early, 10-2. In and out. So each team goes 1-for-2 to start the game at the free throw line, and it's a 1-1 game. 6:45 left here in this first quarter. Alma back home. They've been on the road for about a month. Have not been in this building since early December. Miles Kendrick, little contact, no foul. Tremonti Smith kicks it around to Boggs. They go outside to Kendrick on the baseline. Miles drives in, lays it in. Miles has got his first bucket. And the Airedales take the lead 3-1. Kendrick, 8 points, 6 points a game for the Airedales. 3 point shot for the Panthers is no good. The rebound, Easton Boggs. Here's Kermani Smith, kicks it outside to Camden Kurt. Camden drives in, stops, hands it off, and a nice assist and a layup to Towns Robinson. Izzy's got three, and Alma leads it 5-1. Really nice play from Camden Curd. And we got a turnover, maybe. Got a jump, scramble for it. Look out down there. Got all kind of contact. And we got a timeout called by Tim Stewart. 5:34 to play in the first quarter. It's a 30-second timeout. So, again, this week the Airedales are going to hit the highway on Friday night, Russellville. And then Alma's going to be back home Tuesday night, Van Buren, and back on the road next Friday night against Greenbrier, after that against Greenbrier, and then the first round will wrap up. Alma's going to be home for about a week and a half. They'll have Greenwood at home and Mountain Home at home. 5 minutes and 34 seconds left here in this first quarter. 5-1, Alma's got the lead. And going to send a shout-out to McKinley McCart. She really took a spill and hit her head on the court. So hopefully she's okay. And that's tough in that girls' game. And the girls saw their lead cut down to 4, but then kicked it back up to 11 and hung on to get the win. And Coach Bottom's first conference win as the head coach for the Lady Airedales. 5:25 to play here in this first quarter. Panthers have it back on offense. Moving it around. Up, no good. They got the rebound. Sheer Schwinger, no good again. And the rebound, Towns Robinson. So good defense from Alma. It's 5-1. They've got it back again, looking to extend that lead. Easton Boggs down to Izzy. Izzy puts it up and in. Izzy has got five. And the Airedale's up 7-1. He's a factor in not only offense, but defense. He's just a heck of an athlete. Panthers drive it in, put it up, no good. Rebounded by the Airedales. Camden Kurtz got it. Here's a three-point shot for Boggs. Bingo! Alma leads it 10-1. So the Airedales off and running here in the first quarter of play. They've reeled off 9 straight points to take this lead. 3-point shot from Easton, his first bucket tonight. Here's a shot for the Panthers up and in, 10-3. That was Hobaker. So the Airedales have it. They get it down low to Camden Kurd. Camden puts up a little dipsy doodle, no good. Rebounded by Schweringer. And the Panthers get a run out all the way in. Blocked, out of bounds. Great hustle from the Airedales. You got to love that on defense. Tyree McGill checks in for the first time. He'll check in for Towns Robinson. And a steal. Airedales get it. This is Kendrick. Miles hangs on to it and lays it in. Miles has got 4 and a timeout. Tim Stewart. Alma 12 and Siloam Springs 3. That's their second timeout here in the first quarter, first half of play. So the Airedales lead this game 12-3 and a 30-second timeout. Panthers just trying to gather their thoughts. They got 3 timeouts left. Don't normally see 2 timeouts burned in the first 3.5 minutes, but Good crowd on hand. Got the pep band in the building and the dance team, and the cheerleaders are here. And .339 left here in the first quarter. The Alma Airedales enjoy a 12-3 lead against Siloam Springs. And well, going back to Saturday, going back to that second half, Alma's really played well in the last two and a half quarters. They were down at halftime in Harrison, but had a big second half to win that game by 11, and up here early 9, 12-3. Panthers drive it in, get a layup. That's Hawbaker again. He's got 4 points. And the Airedales lead the game by 7, 12-5. Easton Boggs thinking about it. Well, he's a shooter. Of course he is. Got it back. Going to let it go. Easton for three. It's short. And the rebound, Camden Kerr. Going to reset the offense. Gets it to Tyree McGill. Over to Kendrick, who kicks it outside. Tipped out of bounds. They're going to call an offensive foul. Well, had no place to go. And the Panthers in good position to draw the foul. And they get it back after a turnover from Alma. Matthew Rogers will check in. He played well Saturday. He'll check in for the first time. Alma got a lot of big minutes off the bench. It's kind of what they do. They got some guys who can give you a lot of minutes off that bench. They had to track down the basketball. They finally run it down. Pressure in the backcourt. Tyree McGill and the front court along with Carmani Smith for the Airedales. They've got a 12-5 lead, 7-point lead here in the first quarter of play. .15 on the shot clock. A three is up, no good. Rebounded by the Airedales. That's Easton Boggs. Easton back to Carmani Smith, over to Matthew Rogers outside the Boggs. And Carmody going to let one go from three. It's no good. And the rebound is tipped around there, and the Airedales have it. Here's a three for Salazar. Chris Salazar, no good. Another rebound for Alma. Two minutes left here in the first quarter. 12-5, Alma by seven. Here's Carmody. Smith kicks it outside the Boggs. He's got some pressure on him. Tyree McGill slices in, missed it. Boy, nice play, nice move. Just did not get it to drop in. Panthers back the other way. That's Hawbaker. Puts up a little off-balance shot and no good. And the rebound, going to be a jump ball maybe. Yep, and it's going to go back to Alma. So the Airedales have it with a minute 29 to play. And Hudson Boggs will check in for Kermani Smith here in the first quarter of play. Chris Salazar out there, Hudson Boggs, Tyree McGill, Easton Boggs, and Matthew Rogers for the Airedales. 1:24 left here in the first stanza. They get it to Easton, free throw line, jumper good. Easton's got five, and the Airedales back up by nine. It's 14-5. Alma's got a lead here in this first quarter of 9 points, and we're right at 1 minute left here in the first. Hawbaker drives in, lost it. Stolen away from Hudson Boggs. Here comes Alma coming back the other way. Matthew Rogers drives in, puts it up, and going to be an offensive foul. Again, they got good position and nowhere for Matthew to come down on. So a couple of charges and defensive turnovers nonetheless. And the Panthers, who trailed the game by nine, have it back with 45 seconds to play here in the first quarter. Siloam Springs kicks it. That's going to be an offensive foul. Well, turnabout fair play. And Nice job from Chris Salazar, who takes that charge, and Alma's got it back. 35 seconds left here in the first quarter. 35.4, so the shot clock is on. So technically, you're saying technically, there's still shot clock running. Matthew Rogers will set the offense. Now the shot clock at 28. Alma's going to run a little clock here, 13 seconds. They'll play for the last shot. Rogers over to Hudson Boggs, back to Easton. They got to hurry. Here's a little shot. They got to hurry, get it off. Easton Boggs puts it up, and no good, and that'll do it. After one quarter of play, not a good set late, but the Airedales have the lead nonetheless by 9. After one quarter of play, let's take timeout.
Hey, I'm Brent.
I'm Dale. But you have to call me Dragon.
Well, then you have to call me Nightwing.
All right, Nightwing. Let's play a little game. On the count of three, I want you to say your favorite travel center. Don't even think about it. Just say it, all right? One, two, three.
Workman! What's your favorite deli item? Chicken strips!
Do we become best friends?
Yeah.
All right.
Let's go to Workman's.
Workman's?
Yeah! All right, now that we're finally here, what's your favorite homemade deli or jam? Peach jam! Me too!
Yeah.
Wow. Look at all the amazing honeys and jams. And all these other goodies.
Wow. Excuse me, ma'am. That looks delicious. Oh, burger. That's my burger. They're really good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was amazing. Look at the wide variety it gets.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Workman's! Yeah!
Winner.
Well, good start for the Lady Air of the Airedales. I'm getting my game straight here. Boys game. Lady Airedales got that win, 46-38. And the Airedales off to a good start, 14-5 after one quarter of play. Panthers have the opening possession to start the second quarter. Matthew Rogers, Chris Salazar, Tyree McGill, Hudson Boggs, and Eddie's checked in. Eddie Tate. Boy, Eddie had a big game on Saturday for the Airedales. Bunch of rebounds. Panthers have it. They almost throw it away. Here's Hawbaker on the baseline. He turns it over. Good play from Tyree McGill. He got his hand in there and knocked that thing away. And Alma gets the ball back. 7.5 to play in the first half. Here is Matthew Rogers for three. It's no good. And the rebound, Eddie Tate at it again. Eddie Tate had 12 rebounds, 6 points on Saturday. Here's a Salazar for three. No good. Tate, another rebound. Eddie's got two more rebounds. Gets a pass inside, puts it up. No good. But he'll shoot two foul shots with 7-11 to play in the first half.
Foul charge number two, Evan Allen. Eddie Tate.
So the Airedales getting her done. Eddie Tate's foul shot is up and no good. He'll get one more. Eddie has had a career high of 8 points twice this year, and Saturday got six. He had a huge basket late in that first half that cut it to three at halftime. He got he missed them both. And a rebound, Alma. Salazar lays it up and in.
Chris Salazar.
Chris Salazar's first bucket, and Alma leads it by 11 points now. Largest lead, 16-5. Here is Hawbaker, blocked from Eddie. I don't think they know Eddie can jump. And they're going to call a two-shot foul. And Hawbaker is going to be shooting foul shots with 6:56 to play in the first half. And Eddie's got ups. He can get up on you. Hawbaker's foul shot is no good. He's got 4 points to lead the way for the Panthers. They only have five in that first quarter of play, and he's got four of them. One more foul shot to come with 6:56 to play here in the first half. One out of two to make it a 16-6 ball game. 5 points for Mr. Hawbaker, Nathan, senior. Tyree McGill's got it across midcourt to Matthew Rogers. Matthew down low to McGill, and a foul called against the Panthers. Two team fouls on Solomon Springs with 6:37 left here in this first half.
Now charge number 23, Eli Mann.
Salazar trying to get a pass down low, gets it back, thinking about it, gets it outside to McGill. McGill gets a little baseline shots up and good. 3-point shot for the Airedales, Hudson Boggs. And the Airedales have their biggest lead, 19-6. And a foul called against Alma, reach-in foul, and the Panthers are going to have it on the baseline, I believe.
Foul charge number 5, Matthew Rogers.
Nope, they're going to call that a two-shot foul. So two free throws for the Panthers coming up here, and this is at the charity stripe, A.J. Moore. A.J. got the first one to roll in. He's got one more coming. And he got them both, 19-8. Now the leads it by 11 points. And Coach Lincoln, he likes the fact you've got all that depth and he's got backups out there the first couple minutes here of this second quarter. That's a huge thing to have your way. Here's a 3-point shot. Airedales is up, no good. Eddie Tater rebound. Boy, Eddie can rebound, can he? And the Airedales throw it away. That's three rebounds for Tate. And the Panthers back the other way and got a travel, no call, and a pass and a layup, no good, but a foul called against Alma. That's three fouls here in the second quarter on the Airedales.
Foul charge number 5, Matthew Rogers, his third.
That's on Matthew Rogers. He's got three fouls. So he'll have to check out probably. One thing about it, when you watch the Airedales practice, it's all intermingle. It's not like starters only. Everybody kind of plays together. They kind of mix and match, and that's by design. Foul shots up and in. So the Panthers, shooting a lot of free throws, have four straight foul shots to get within 9 points, 19-10. Towns Robinson about to check in for the Airedales. Rogers outside the box. Hudson back over to Matthew. 5.5 to play in the first half, and the shot clock down to 15. They get a lob inside to Eddie Tate. Tate lays it up and in. Eddie's first basket. And now we're back up by 11 points, and the starters will check in momentarily. That's a great problem to have, isn't it? Let your guys get a nice little rest over there. 3-point shot for the Panthers. A short rebounded by the Panthers. They get it right back. Here's a turnaround shot. Tough basket up and in. That's Evan Allen. Alma's lead back to 9, 21-12 with 4:40 to play in the first half. Here's Tyree McGill, drives in, lets it up, no good, but a foul. I'm going to call it that on the floor. So that's going to be team foul number 3 against Siloam Springs, and the Airedales are going to get 5 fresh players in the game, the starting 5 back out there. Great job by the defense, the backups. 21-12, Alma by 9, they've got it out of bounds. Carmody Smith will inbound it. Gets it to Izzy, lost it. And the Panthers coming down the other way. Here's Allen, up and in. Evan Allen, a couple of baskets back-to-back, and suddenly the lead down to just 7. Alma led it by as many as 13. 19-6, but right now the lead back to just 7, 21-14. 4 minutes and 10 seconds left here in the first half. They get a pass down to Towns. Robinson lays it up, no good, and a rebound Panthers. And a run out for Siloam Springs. They throw it away. So the Airedales get it right back. Under 4 minutes left here in the first half, and Alma's got the ball, and they get it to Towns Robinson across midcourt, outside to Camden Curd. 3:45 to play in the first half. 21-14, Alma Airedale lead here from Airedale Arena. Box to Towns Robinson, kicks it down low. Here's a shot for Curd, no good, and the rebound going to go back to the Panthers. Alma's missed a couple of chippies in there, and 21-14 lead. Panthers have it back. They can get a little bit closer. And a timeout for the Airedales. Their first timeout here. Going to be a 30-second timeout. So we'll keep it right here with you. Once again, the Lady Airedales picked up their first conference win tonight as they knock off the Panthers of Siloam Springs, 46-38. 14 points for Jaden Gramlich. 11 points for Jordan Gramlich, and 9 big points for McKinley McCart. And the Airedales had a big lead. They led that game wire to wire. Never trailed. Led 11-0, 24-7. Saw the Panthers get within 4, 37-33, but Alma kind of took it over after that. And they win the ball game by 8 points. 46-38. So the Panthers, Siloam Springs, have it back. They trail at 21-14 here in the first half. Swearinger's got it, top of the three-point line. Going to drive in. Evan Allen passed it off. Hawbaker's got it back to Allen. Allen going to set up, shoot a three-point shot. He traveled, no call, made the basket. Holy cow. Looked like he moved his feet to get a better angle. And the Airedales suddenly up just 4. 19-6 to 21-17. And the Panthers in that zone defense. Here's Izzy, turnaround jumper, no good. Izzy got the rebound, puts it back up, and a foul called against Siloam Springs. And Towns Robinson going to shoot 2 free throws.
Foul charge number 32, Cooley Webb, his first.
Izzy at the charity stripe, foul shot is short. He's 1 out of 3 tonight, 1 more to come. He's got 5 points. He had 5 early points for the Airedales. Got off to a quick 7-1 lead, then 10-1 at one point. Free throws up. He missed them both. And the rebound, Camden Curd's got it. Airedales having a dickens of a time with the charity stripe. Here is Towns Robinson. Lays it up. Missed it. Got it again. Puts it up and in. He kept battling. And Izzy's got 7, and the Alma lead back to 6, 23-17. They get a backdoor cut, but a foul called against Alma with 2:18 to play. That's 14 fouls apiece on each team, and Panthers have it out of bounds. So from here on out, it'll be free throws for each team. Next time there's a foul called. 2:17 to play. Panthers kick it outside. Hawbaker drives in, puts it up and in. Nice move by the left-hander and got it to drop in. Alma leads it by 4, 23-19. Three-point shot for the Airedales. Miles Kendrick drops it in. And the Airedales lead it by 7, 26-19. Schweringer, no good. Rebounded by the Airedales. Here comes Alma. They got numbers. Izzy drives in, puts it up, missed it. Rebounded by the Airedales, up, no good, missed it again. And off Siloam Springs. And the Airedales have it out of bounds, 1:40 to play in the first half. 1:41 to be exact. Big shot for Miles Kendrick. He's got 7 points. Well, the Airedales have missed probably 3 or 4 easy buckets. Here's a 3-point shot, no good. Swearinger with the rebound. And the Panthers coming back the other way. Shot up, no good, but a foul called against Camden Curd.
Foul charge number 1, Camden Curd, his first.
And free throws again for Siloam Springs. Airedales have really struggled shooting foul shots here tonight. And only have a 7-point lead. Feels like a lot more. Foul shots good. 26-20 ball game and a chance to cut it within five. Free throws up, and that one is no good. Easton Boggs a rebound. So a minute 20 left here in the first half. Alma by 6, 26-20. Kendrick kicks it outside. Camden Kerr stops. Little baseline shots, in and out, no good. Panthers have another rebound. Alma's getting some good looks, good shots. Panthers driving up, wild shot, no good. Easton Boggs, another rebound. Here's Easton Boggs for three. That's good. Big shot from Easton. And the Airedales back up by 9 points, 29-20. Easton's got eight. Here's a drive, no good, rebounded by the Airedales, a run out. This is Miles Kendrick, got Izzy with him as well. He's fouled, puts it up, no good. And two free throws for Kendrick with 18.7 seconds left here in the first half. Alma chance to go back up by double digits here before halftime. Tyree McGill will check in for the Airedales here momentarily. Kendrick up and in. Miles has got eight. That's his average. He came in averaging 8.6 points a game, and right now it's 8 points here in this game here in the first half. Really good balance. 8 points for Boggs, 8 points for Kendrick, and seven for Towns Robinson. Make it nine for Kendrick, and he will check out. Miles has two fouls, so obviously you want to get him out. No cheap foul to end this first half. 15 seconds left. Alma's going to have a halftime lead right now. It's 31-20. Panthers hand it off. Here's a wild shot up. No good. And a scramble for it. Alma's got it. Towns Robinson's got to hurry. Izzy stops, pops, puts it up. Oh, he missed it. Heck of an effort. And at halftime, it's Alma 31, Siloam Springs 20. Let's take timeout.
Ça blesse, ça flingue. Aïe, 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 grip, bro. Gazo, aïe, aïe, aïe. Grip, clic, bro. Ça tue, ça blesse, ça flingue. Aïe, 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 grip, bro. Gazo, aïe, aïe, aïe. Grip, clic.
Accidents are never fun. Don't take your vehicle to just anyone. The professional team at Autoplex is committed to quality first and your complete satisfaction. Our ASE certified technicians will repair your vehicle to pre-accident condition efficiently and quickly with a warranty on all repairs, on-site insurance filing, and rental cars available. At Autoplex, we look forward to making your experience with us easy in our state-of-the-art facility. Autoplex Collision Repair. Quality first, always.
In 1886, aluminum was developed. The first Coca-Cola was sold. The Statue of Liberty was dedicated. And Citizens Bank and Trust in Crawford County opened for business. We say, they don't make things like they used to. And maybe that's true. But for over 130 years, Citizens has served the residents of Crawford County with the best financial products and services available. And like aluminum, Coca-Cola, and the Statue of Liberty, we plan on being around for a while. Citizens Bank and Trust. That's my bank for all of Crawford County.
Come again.
Crabtree RV Center, leading the River Valley in sales and service for over 70 years. Founded in 1950, Crabtree RV Center has grown into one of the largest family-owned and operated RV dealerships in Northwest Arkansas. Located on 17 acres, including a 26,000 square foot indoor showroom, Crabtree RV Center has everything you need, all in one convenient location. Crabtree RV Center in Alma, Arkansas, making your family's dreams come true.
You know, we may not all agree on everything, but when we walk through these doors, we can have one thing in common, and that's Jesus.
With all the stuff going on in the world, all the good, all the bad, this church has been something constant for me and my family four generations back, and something that can stay constant for my kids going forward. They're still the same church, and they're still the same people that I can still depend on and go to when I need something.
Heritage Portraits has proudly provided photography services for the River Valley and surrounding areas for over 20 years, including school photography and yearbooks, youth sports leagues, corporate photography, studio sessions, and event photography. Have you been meaning to order your child's school photos? Walk-ins are welcome, and we offer on-site printing. We are located at 402 Webster Street in Van Buren. Contact us today. We're ready to photograph you.
Omega Car and Truck Accessories would like to invite you to come by and take a tour of our new retail showroom behind Brahms in Alma. Interactive working displays and a fully stocked warehouse allow you to pick out today's hottest accessories and get them installed fast. Wheels and tires, audio video, LED lighting, steps, lift kits, bed liners, custom interiors, towing, computer cut window tinting, Omega does it all. And with certified technicians, we guarantee the job will be done right. If customer service and value are important to you, choose Omega Car and Truck Accessories.
Spartan General Contractors is a construction company equipped with highly trained and experienced individuals ready to support you with your next construction project. Residential or commercial, Spartan has the resources needed to help you achieve your final goal. One of our main objectives at Spartan is to keep your project on time and within your budget. While the thoughts of your next construction job can seem complex and overwhelming, let Spartan General Contractors help alleviate that stress and make your next project become reality.
Here at the University of Arkansas Fort Smith, we do things differently.
Because here, learning doesn't just happen on screens and in books. We learn through action.
With degree plans that are on our terms, whether in class or online.
And because UAEFS is the most affordable four-year campus in Arkansas,
we can do it all without going into debt.
So when we graduate, we don't just have a diploma. We have a resume that will launch our careers.
Hey, I'm Brent.
I'm Dale, but you have to call me Dragon.
Well, then you have to call me Nightwing.
All right, Nightwing. Let's play a little game. On the count of three, I want you to say your favorite travel center. Don't even think about it, just say it, all right? One, two, three,
Workman! What's your favorite deli item?
Chicken strips!
Do we just become best friends?
Yeah!
All right!
Let's go to Workman's!
Workman's?
Yeah!
All right, now that we're finally here, what's your favorite homemade deli or jam?
Peach jam!
Me too!
Yeah.
Wow, look at all the amazing honeys and jams, and all these other goodies.
Wow! Excuse me, ma'am, that looks delicious.
Oh, burger, that's my burger.
They're really good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was amazing. Look at the wide variety of gifts.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Workman's.
Yeah!
Lumber One is a locally owned lumber yard located in Van Buren, Arkansas, down on Industrial Park Road. We've been in business since 2002, and our vision is to provide quality building materials to the professional builder and to the do-it-yourselfer at competitive prices. Lumber One offers a full line of lumber, unfinished and finished plywood, engineered wood, cedar products, and LP smart siding and trim, along with access to James Hardy siding and other pre-finished siding. We also carry roofing, insulation materials, drywall, and wood sidings like shiplap siding, cedar lap and gap, and car siding. Our full-line door shop can handle all your door, window, and trim needs. We offer several different exterior door and glass options from Therma-True, MAI Doors, and Western Reflections. We also stock several different interior door styles from Gelled Wen, with access to their entire interior door line and others. We have a full-time estimator on staff who can do blueprint takeoffs and estimated material list for whatever project you have. He can work with contractors or homeowners to help you get your project started and answer any questions you may have. You'll also have access to an outside sales representative that will be there throughout the building process from start to finish. Our mission is to provide service at a level that differentiates us as the best in the marketplace. Lumber One, where service still matters.
Bro, ça tue, ça blesse, ça flingue. Bro, gazo. Ça tue, ça blesse, ça flingue. Aïe, 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 grip, bro. Gazo.
Accidents are never fun. Don't take your vehicle to just anyone. The professional team at Autoplex is committed to quality first and your complete satisfaction. Our ASE certified technicians will repair your vehicle to pre-accident condition efficiently and quickly with a warranty on all repairs, on-site insurance filing, and rental cars available. At Autoplex, we look forward to making your experience with us easy in our state-of-the-art facility. Autoplex Collision Repair. Quality first, always.
In 1886, aluminum was developed. The first Coca-Cola was sold. The Statue of Liberty was dedicated. And Citizens Bank and Trust in Crawford County opened for business. We say, they don't make things like they used to. And maybe that's true. But for over 130 years, Citizens has served the residents of Crawford County with the best financial products and services available. And like aluminum, Coca-Cola, and the Statue of Liberty, we plan on being around for a while. Citizens Bank and Trust. That's my bank for all of Crawford County.
Halftime wrapping up, and the Airedales and Panthers are getting ready for the second half. Alma's going to have the opening possession. They saw that lead of 13 cut down to 4, 23-19, but a nice run to end that first half. An 8-1 run, and the Airedales at halftime had themselves the 31-20 advantage. So on a cold night here in January, and good place to be in nice, warm arena. Airedales back on the floor. It's going to be the starting five. Kermani Smith, Camden Curt, Easton Boggs, Israel Towns Robinson, and big first half for Miles Kendrick. Miles had 8 points in that first half. 9 points for the Airedales. So 9 points for Miles, 8 for Easton Boggs, and 7 for Towns Robinson. And here we go, opening start here of the second half. Alma trying to go to 2-0 in the conference. They get a pass down low to Izzy. Izzy, good ball movement, doubled up, kicks it back outside. Easton Boggs from way downtown, bingo! And the Airedales have their largest lead tonight, 34-20. Easton Boggs got 11. 3-point shot for the Panthers. Left wing is good. And the lead cut back down to 11 points. So good answer for the Panthers. They get that ball to drop in right away.
Easton Boggs
again. Boom. And the Airedales back up again, 14. Broken record. Easton's got 14 points here tonight. Cole Pittman had that 3-point shot. Tim Stewart, unhappy, calls a full timeout. 7:02 to play here in this third quarter. It's Alma 37, Siloam Springs 23. We'll be right back.
Okay.
Well, the Airedales have themselves a 37-23 advantage here in this third quarter of play. Easton Boggs, a couple of three-point buckets, and Easton's got 14. Miles Kendrick has 9 and 7 for Towns Robinson. That's 30 points right there, 30 of the 37 from the big three. And again, it's just about balance, and it's a roster and a team that likes each other, and they play well together, and nobody's really worried about who's got what. And you take Camden Curd, who's a great, outstanding player, has got no points here tonight. No points for Kamadi Smith, but what matters is the 14-point lead in the second half. Here's a drive up and in. A little backdoor cut, and the Panthers have a chance to get back within 11. Basket, it's Hawbaker up and in. Free throw's good. So teams are trading three-point plays and shots here. And I'm led by 11 at halftime. The lead's back to 11 right now, 37-26. They get it down low to Izzy. Puts it up and no good, but he's fouled, and he'll shoot two foul shots. So Towns Robinson, 7 points in that first half. His first chance here in the second half. It's up and no good. He'll get one more. Izzy is 1 out of 5 at the charity stripe. One more foul shot to come. And 1 out of 2. He drilled that one. 38-26, Allen by 12. Izzy's got 8. Three-point shots on the way. It's no good. The long rebound. Swearinger's got it down low, and it's tipped around and taken away from Miles Kendrick. And a long pass to Camden Curd, back to Boggs, and Easton outside to Kermani Smith. Baseline shot for the Airedales. No good. That was Curd. And Camden misfired. Panthers coming back the other way. They get a layup down low for 2. That'll cut it down to 10. 38-28 with under 6 to play here in this third quarter. Once again, Friday night, Alma is going to be heading over to Russellville. They got a really nice arena. If you've never been over there, it's really, really nice. 3-point shot for the Airedales, and it's no good. And the Panthers have a rebound. And the Panthers, that's going to be an make all a block on that. Wow. Thought we might have an offensive foul, but the official called a block on Camden Curd. That's his second foul. Airedales have some backups coming back in. Eddie Tate checks in for the first time here in the second half, and Tyree McGill and Chris Salazar are in the ballgame. Here's the lob, and got a jump ball, and great effort from Eddie Tate, but it's going to stay with the Panthers. The arrow favored their side of the ball. Here's an inbound shot up, no good, and another rebound, Eddie Tate. I tell you, 4 rebounds for Mr. Tate, and the Airedales up 10, get it back. Chris Salazar had a couple of points in that first half. Here's a shot for Salazar. It's no good. And a rebound, Panthers. Here comes Solomon Springs, a chance to get within 8. That's a push-off, no call. Blocked! But they call goaltending, so count the basket. From Eddie Tate, it's 38-30. Hudson Boggs will check in for the Airedales. Look like Chris Salazar might have got popped on the head there. He'll be checked out from Patty Webb. Under 5 minutes left here in this third quarter, and Alma leads it by 8 points. They had a 14-point lead a minute ago, but the Panthers, they keep scratching and clawing. They're back within 8. 4:45 now showing on the clock. Tyree McGill's got it. Gets a good pass to Easton Boggs. Missed it. And the rebound, Panthers. Swearinger's got it. Here comes Solomon Springs. They can get within five. And might have had some steps. They did. Travel. Airedales get it back. Matthew Rogers will check in. Second half, first time for the Airedales. Almost got all five backups in the game right now with 4 minutes and 19 seconds left here in the third quarter. They've got an eight-point lead. Hudson Boggs had a big three-point shot in that first half. Hudson going to launch another one. That's short, and the Panthers get the rebound. Here's Hawbaker. Looking to give it away and does so. Gray has got it. 3:45 to play in third. And here's a drive inside and a layup from Swearinger. No good! He got the rebound and puts it back in for two. Well, he missed it, got his rebound, and the Alma lead down to 6, 38-32. Alma had a 37-23 lead. Here's Matthew Rogers. What a alley-oop to slam dunk it home for Eddie Tate. Hello. That'll get you going. Now we're back up by 8, 40-32. Three-point shot for the Panthers, no good. Hudson Boggs a rebound. Eddie Tate is a kid who did not get much playing time as a ninth grader, none at all. And he's just made himself a heck of a player. Alma throws it away, could not hang on to it, so the Panthers get it back again. He's just kept battling, and, you know, sometimes that'll happen. That guy's just, the light goes on, and he grew a little bit, and Eddie's going to check out. Great effort. Towns Robinson back in for Alma. Panthers trail at 40-32 with 2:40 to play here in the third quarter. Here's a three-point shot top of the circle. It's no good, and a rebound Panthers. Izzy had it. Might have had a foul, no call, and it goes right to the Panthers who get the layup to cut it back to 6, 40-34. Carmani Smith back in for Alma as well. And Miles Kendrick is out there. 2:10 to play in the third, Alma by 6. Carmody Smith, top of the circle for three. No good. And the rebound is going to stay with Alma. 2 minutes left here in the third quarter. Carmody Smith going to inbound it. Alma leads it by 6. They've led it all the way, but you feel like it ought to be a bigger lead. Here is Izzy up and no good. And the rebound, Panthers get it back. Under 2 to play in the third quarter, a 6-point game for the Airedales. Swearinger's got it on the block, puts it up, had it blocked. Oh, that was clean. They called a foul on Towns Robinson, I believe. And the Airedales, that's their third foul here in this second half, third quarter. And two free throws for the Panthers, and they could get within four with a minute 39. First foul shots up and in. Foul was not on Izzy. They're not showing. I guess the foul must have been on Tyree McGill. Free throws are good, so the Panthers trail it by 4, 40-36, with a minute 35 to play here in the third quarter. Alma led by 11 at halftime. Matthew Rogers to Kermani Smith. Rogers back to Smith. They move it around. Good ball movement. Tyree McGill. And the ball's tipped. They got to hurry. 9 seconds on the shot clock. 1:10 to play in the third quarter. Tremonti Smith, the Hudson box. 3-point shot's up and no good. Panthers have the rebound. 1 minute to play in the third. Stolen away. Matthew Rogers got it. Puts it up and in. Huge play for Matthew Rogers. Alma by 6. Here's a foul called against Alma. You could almost hear that whistle before the play even started. That was an interesting call. 4 fouls on the Airedales, and looks like that's a shooting foul. Panthers at the charity stripe for 2 more foul shots with 47 seconds left. First one's short. Boy, big layup 1 minute ago for Matthew Rogers after a turnover. 1 more free throw coming, 47.3 to play in the third quarter. Missed them both, rebounded by the man of the hour, Matthew Rogers. Got the rebound, had the big bucket 1 minute ago, and 40 seconds left. Alma could extend that lead back to 8. They missed it. They led at halftime by 11, but Alma missed probably 4 or 5 easy shots inside. Here's a layup. Miles Kendrick, another one, and the Airedales back up by 8, 44-36, with under 15 seconds left here in the third quarter. Schwager gets it down low. Good movement, good move by the Panthers. They get the bucket to fall. Scoreboard's wrong. I believe it's 44-38. It shows 42. Here's a shot that's up and no good. There it is. And after 3, it's Alma 44 in Siloam Springs 38. Let's take timeout.
Crabtree RV Center, leading the River Valley in sales and service for over 70 years. Founded in 1950, Crabtree RV Center has grown into one of the largest family-owned and operated RV dealerships in Northwest Arkansas. Located on 17 acres, including a 26,000 square foot indoor showroom, Crabtree RV Center has everything you need, all in one convenient location. Crabtree RV Center in Alma, Arkansas, making your family's dreams come true.
You know, we may not all agree on everything, but when we walk through these doors, we can have one thing in common, and that's Jesus.
With all the stuff going on in the world, all the good, all the bad, this church has been something constant for me and my family 4 generations back, and something that can stay constant for my kids going forward. They're still the same church, and they're still the same people that I can still depend on and go to when I need something.
Back at Airedale Arena, the Airedales have themselves a 6-point lead to start the fourth quarter of play, and the Panthers will have the ball to start this fourth quarter. Alma had a pretty nice lead there after a little bit of time, 14 points early on in the third quarter, but the Panthers cut it to 6 after 3, 44-38. Yeah, you got to feel like the Airedales really had some layups, just did not drop in early in that first half. And here we go with the fourth quarter of play. Matthew Rogers stays out there. Camden Curry checks back in. Towns Robinson stays on the floor. And Miles Kendrick's got himself a nice game going, 11 points. Panthers put it up and it rolls in. Man, 4-point game, 44-40. So the Airedales trying to get their first conference win at home and go to 2-0 in the league. And they got to hurry to get it across midcourt, and they just barely do. Now we get a timeout or something. Nope, backcourt. Backcourt violation. And the Airedales lead it by 4, and the Panthers have it. 7:22 to play here in this fourth quarter. Now I'm about 4 points, 44-40. Getting a little bit dicey here in this fourth quarter of play. Panthers drive it in. No good, but another foul against Alma. No, but travel. They called the travel. No foul. And the Airedales have it back. 7:07 to play in the game, and they're going to get it across midcourt. Try to. This time they do successfully. Under 7 minutes left here in the game, and Camden Curd outside to Matthew Rogers. Here is Miles Kendrick, little jumper, no good, and the Panthers have a rebound. Solomon Springs back the other way, 6:30 left here in the game. And the Airedales trying to hold on. Offense got a little bit stagnant. They get a backdoor cut and a layup. And just like that, it's a 44-42 game. Alma up two. They had a 14-point lead, 37-23. But right now, the lead's down to just 2 points. Under 6 minutes left to play, and the Airedales' three-point shot baseline's up, no good. Rebounded by the Airedales. Camden Curd's got it. Here's a three-point shot for Alma. Bingo! Boy, that's a big one. Easton Boggs has got 17, and Alma by five. Huge second-chance possession for the Airedales on that one. .529 left to play, and the Panthers with 15 on the shot clock running the clock. Here's a wide open three up and good. Man, they left him alone. He made it. And the Airedales back up again by 2 points. Here's Rogers on a run out. Gets it down to Towns Robinson. He lost it. Nope, he's fouled. It's going to be on the ball out of bounds. That's the second team foul here in the second or fourth quarter on the Panthers.
His first. Carmody Smith in for the Airedales.
Carmody Smith will check in for Matthew Rogers. Almost got it out of bounds. 5:08 to play in the game. 3-point shot, baseline up and in.
Matthew Rogers.
And that's Rogers who drilled it. He stayed in the game. My bad. So Matthew Rogers got a big 3-point shot. He's got five, and the Airedales have a 5-point lead, 50-45. Panthers have it. And the ball tipped away, stolen away from Towns Robinson. Izzy's running the other way. Puts it up, and blocking foul called against the Panthers, and two foul shots for Towns Robinson.
Foul charge number 21, Nathan Hallmaker. His second.
That's on Nathan Hallmaker, his second foul. And we got ourselves a timeout. It's going to be a full timeout, Panthers. They only got one left. So 4:33 left to play in the game, and the Airedales lead this ball game by 5 points. We'll be right back.
Heritage Portraits has proudly provided photography services for the River Valley and surrounding areas for over 20 years, including school photography and yearbooks, youth sports leagues, corporate photography, studio sessions, and event photography. Have you been meaning to order your child's school photos? Walk-ins are welcome, and we offer on-site printing. We are located at 402 Webster Street in Van Buren. Contact us today. We're ready to photograph you.
Back in the arena, we got the pep band going, and pretty nip-and-tuck game here suddenly. The Airedales and Siloam Springs Panthers. Alma led by 14, led by 13 in the first half, 11 at halftime, and then early in the second half took a 37-23 advantage, but the Panthers have cut it to within two. A big three-point shot earlier from Matthew Rogers, and now the lead is five. And Towns Robinson going to have two foul shots, 8 points for Izzy tonight. 17 points in the game for Easton Boggs to lead all scorers. Nathan Hawbaker's got 16 to lead the Panthers. Izzy's foul shot is good. That's a big one. Alma leads it by 6, 4:33 left to play here in this game. They have not trailed. The Airedales have led it all the way. Next free throw from Towns Robinson's up. That one's good again. Izzy back to back. Alma by 7, 52-45. Four minutes and 20 seconds left here in this basketball game. Alma by 7. And the Panthers throw it away. So good defense. Alma forces a turnover, and they get it back. Pressure is getting the Panthers in the 2-2-1. Trying to get that ball back. They trail it by 7 points. 4 minutes and 14 seconds left here in this game. seconds on the shot clock. Carmani Smith runs the offense. Camden Curd gets it down to Izzy. Izzy spins inside, kicks it back outside the box. 3-point shot for Easton's up. No good. And the rebound, Izzy. Izzy back up and in. And the foul. Twelve points for Towns Robinson and a free throw to come here with a 3:50 to play in the game. Izzy, good. Boy, some clutch free throws down the stretch. Alma by 10. They led it 44-42, and then since then, it's an 11-3 run for the Airedales. Panthers ball tipped around from the Airedales, but it's going to stay with Siloam. Got 14 on the shot clock. Friday night, Alma's going to be on the road. They'll be down the highway in Russellville, back home next Tuesday. If we survive all the cold weather coming, holy cow, here's a reach-in foul called against Easton Boggs. That is going to be his second foul. And for the Airedales, team foul number 1 here in this fourth quarter.
Foul charge number 15, Easton Boggs, his second.
Panthers have it. New shot clock, but the game clock down to 3:20. And the ball stolen away. Towns Robinson got his hand in there. And a reach-in foul called against the Panthers. That's 14 fouls on Siloam here in the fourth quarter. With 3:13 to play, the Airedales have it out of bounds. Carmani Smith got it, gets it across midcourt. 3 minutes and 9 seconds left here in this basketball game, and the Airedales, Easton Boggs drives in, puts it up, and oh, he missed it. Boy, good look, just didn't drop in. And the Airedales still lead by 10, under 3 to play. Here's a shot for the Panthers, is up and good. That's Gray, Evan Gray. And the Airedales lead it by, lead is 8. Airedales trying to run a little clock here. Shot clock down to 10. 2:20 left here in the game, and the Airedales up 55-47. Now they got to run the play. Carmody Smith drives in, puts it up, and they're going to call an offensive foul. Wow. Carmody Smith made the basket, but an offensive foul called against the Airedales. So 2:13 to play. Alma's going to press a little bit. They'll have some guys in the backcourt. Coming up on 2 minutes left here in the game. Alma by 8. Panthers working the ball around. Under 2 minutes left here to play. Shot clock is at 11. And a steal from Towns Robinson. Gets it over to Camden Curt. And here we go. The Airedales coming down the other way. Camden's going to get it outside to Carmody Smith. A minute 35 left. The Airedales by 8. Tremonti to Izzy. Puts it off the glass and in for two, and the lead back to 10. Great play from Towns Robinson, and an even better play from Kermani Smith, a good dish. And Alma leads the ball game by 10. Three-point shot, Panthers no good. Rebounded by the Airedales. And coming up on a minute left, Alma by 10 points. A pass to Izzy. He puts it in for two more. And the Airedales lead it by 12. Some contact down there, and the Airedales take the lead now 59-47. I think we had a foul after the play. Well, the foul's on Solemn Springs, so it's going to be an and one for Towns Robinson. With a minute 3 left, down by 12, and we are coming up on how sweet it is time. Free throw good. Izzy's got 18. And the Airedales lead this ball game by 13 points. What a weird game, Alma. You really felt like they were in control, and then suddenly in this fourth quarter, the lead was down to two. But boy, they've turned it on, 44-42, and now it's 60-47. So what a closeout, 16-5 run for the Airedales. Gray puts it up and got it to roll in, and a timeout, last timeout for the Panthers, 60-49 with 45 ticks left to play in the game. Full timeout for Solemn Springs. Let's stay right here and want to thank again everybody with Airwaves Media tonight on this cold night. And my man Lewis doing a good job as always. You betcha. Airedales up 11 points, trying to get it to 2-0 in conference, and also go up 9-8. It'd be on the plus side in conference play. And Russellville, really good. They're playing Greenbrier tonight. They've played a ton of home games, and they finally back on the road tonight as they were taking on the Greenbrier Panthers. Mountain Home was 1-0. Alma was 1-0. Russellville 1-0. And Van Buren 1-0. So that's your early leaderboard in the 5A West for the boys. As the Lady Airedales won their game earlier tonight, congrats to Chan Lee Bottoms and got her first conference win as a head coach. Miles Kidrick gets it over to Easton Boggs, and the Airedales have it across midcourt. 35 seconds left. This is it, boys. How sweet it is. Airedales are going to be 2-0 in the conference. 28 seconds left. Got 15 on the shot clock. They get it down to Izzy. Spins, puts it up, no good. The rebound, Alma. They're going to kick it back outside. 14 seconds left. That'll do it. Alma's going to win this ball game. You betcha. And Coach Dominic Leakin's team now 2-0 in the 5A West. A big win over Solemn Springs as Alma gets the win here at home tonight. And the Airedales win it. 18 points for Towns Robinson, 17 for Easton Boggs, and the Airedales go to 2-0 in the 5A West. So congrats to Coach Dominic Lincoln and company as Alma stays hot. They've won three in a row overall, and they go to 2-0 in the conference. Big game with the Cyclones Friday night. We'll be with you Friday night from Russellville High School. This is Kevin Taylor for Airwaves Media saying so long from Airedale Arena. Good night, everybody.
Your Alma High School alma mater.